What's going on, everybody? Before we get into the exposed part of the video, I was trying to experiment with people to swerve with. Right now, I just don't really care about any receiver because they all do the same animations. Everybody drops the ball. It's something that is going to be going on. They just did a patch, but I'm pretty sure everybody's going to get the same animations and everybody's going to still drop the ball. So pretty much for me, I know a lot of dudes run up at the mouth like, yo, bro, if you swerve, it's an exploit. Yeah, that's great, bro. I've been swerving since Madden 09, so it don't really matter, bro. And like I said, it doesn't really matter about the swerve as much as it matters that you don't have defensive control. So until people start to understand that, because in real football, receivers move around like that. They don't, you know, they go inside, outside, whatever like that, but the defender doesn't just stand there like an idiot. You know what I'm saying? So that's what the major issue is. Once they give defensive control back and guys can strafe and move around, which I still have to continue to test out because the patch was just released, I'll let you guys know. But look at this right here, bro. Yo, career tribute Vic though with Willie Brown and Khalil Mack. I didn't even actually see this while the stream was going on because I was actually texting because I had just lost the game to a bum that was in the top 100. And, I was just like, you know, every time Madden starts to make me go crazy, I start to do something else because I got to keep my brain fluids going. I can't continuously focus on this game because then I feel like I have HIV. So I have to, like, you know, try to analyze other things that are going on within my day. Either way, this dude right here, usually these guys that come out that spend all their checks, you know, their retirement fund, because there's a lot of older dudes that play it, and they use their social security checks to buy muck cards. He just has that name, like Mr. T. Rogers. It just seems like an older gentleman. You know what I'm saying? It's nothing wrong with it. If you love Madden, you love Madden. You know what I'm saying? I don't care, you know, you're a girl, boy, whatever, you know what I'm saying, infant. You know, as of 16 and 17, infants can play the game successfully and win. I just think that, you know, people have to understand that it's not, the team doesn't really matter as much, even though they just patched it. And now the offensive line is going to matter more. I don't think it's going to really be that major of an issue. Something is going to be OP. You know what I'm saying? For instance, now when you try to do the Jimmy jump, the dude fumbles the ball every play because they toned it down. They could have just made him not jump as high. You know what I'm saying? Because now you're just prone for turnovers. So I guess you got to find another way to score, which is fine. You know what I'm saying? You have to adapt. But it is like, you know, what is it, the 10th patch? Or I don't even know what it is. But Grunk right there, I kept getting the green circle of death. And then he wants to fight. Yeah, go ahead, fight him, bro. Fight him, because that means more than the gameplay. Yeah, go ahead, put these animations in. Yeah, fight him, fight him. Yeah, yeah, punch him in the face. Punch him in the face, bro. Yeah, punch him in the face. Yo, this game, look, it doesn't even really matter, bro. Let me just tell you this right now. This dude right here, man, the dude was bringing out the D Jones D from like, Madden 16? But it's not as effective. The two-man under is really not that effective because you could do a lot of different things. It's just the fact that sometimes the animation takes over. So if you're throwing the streak, like, look, even with that C route, even without that dumb animation that they have where the guy just jumps in the air and the ball pops out, they make them come down off the C route a lot of times. And even if you rat catch it, they're still coming down. So it doesn't really matter. It just depends on what animation you're going to get. And that's something that I think is really, really wrong for the future of the game. Because when you just let the animation take over, you take more away from the user. That's an issue for me. You know, for a lot of people that can't use her, I actually had some guys in my stream that came in there and they were honest about it. They said, look, I got no user and I love these Maddens. You know, and that's not, there's nothing wrong with that. But that doesn't mean that you take the user away from the people that like the user. You can have it both ways. You know what I'm saying? Like, user can still be there and the other guy just doesn't have to use it and the computer could take over for that. But the human users that really want to utilize that skill should be able to still do that. You know what I'm saying? With the options, just turn off, CPU help and stuff like that. It's very simple to do it. You know what I'm saying? They've done it before. It's in their blueprint, you know, but looking forward to Madden 18 with the Frostbite engine, you know, that's why I'm not really excited about it. You know, more than likely, I'm probably going to be a sucker and get the game regardless, but you never know, man. You know, I might wake up and say, you know what, I'm done with it. You just don't know. We got to take it day by day. But right here, this was very interesting. Look, the mannequin challenge, and John Madden is just so disgusted with it. You know, he's just looking at somebody in the office like, what the hell? Bro, why is that guy just frozen right there? And you know what's crazy? I clicked on him and tried to move him. And more drop picks. I really couldn't move him. In the past, I've never really been able to click on him, but more drop picks. All right, cool. I'm really not able. What is going, yo, is this guy serious? This guy just tried to throw me a pick 3 straight times and EA would not let me pick it. Now he's going to cough and corner me right quick on the 2-yard line. You know, this is what I'm saying. These are the things that are really, really frustrating. But overall, you know, what is that? Okay, now he's dropping picks too. Whatever. Yo, it is what it is, man. EA Sports, do your thing. What is Gronkowski doing? Can't catch the ball? All right, he's going to be out of here, bro. That dude is straight trash. And now he's, bro, why are you walking so slow? Dude's walking like he got a Mandingo. Look at this right here. Look at this. How is he sliding? How is he... Bro, what did... Yo, these guys have to be... And then he's like swiped through his chest. You saw that? Like, the guy swiped through his chest. I don't know, man. Every time I play this game, I feel like I lose years off my life, bruh. But that's neither here nor there, because guess what? I'm choosing to play it. You see, you know what I'm saying? Like that meme with the black guy, like making you, like hitting his head. You gotta think about it like that. You see what I'm saying? Like, yeah, the game is killing me, but I'm choosing voluntarily to do it. So it's not EA Sports' fault. You know what I'm saying? You think it's the crack pipe's fault that you smoking crack? What is this right here, though? What, bruh, how did it even pop? Oh my, bruh, this game. All right, it is what it is. So as you can see, like I told the stream, I'm just coming out to swerve. I don't really care about running an offense, because whenever I try to run a real offense, my guys drop the ball and it's just more frustrating. So I'd rather just throw the ball in the coverage and just see what happens, because that's what everybody does to me. So it's like, whatever. If you're playing quadruple coverage on somebody and he lines up and just throws a hot dot right through your body, yo, he threw that pick right to me. How much seconds am I gonna have left? Because that's my basic Willie Brown. You know, my Willie Brown trash. He got the 99 Willie Brown. That's big time stuff. Right here, you see Grunt, I keep on getting stuck with him. And I don't know what it is. I don't know if they, you know, because I don't usually have issues with that with Cordell Patterson. But I was really getting stuck. And then when I didn't get stuck with the swerve, oh, he was right underneath it. Why didn't he react? I was getting the green circle of death. So I don't know if that's something that's like a new addition to the game, like with the green circle of death to actually enhance your experience. But I wasn't able to do a lot of the things that I was able to do with the other players. But I'm going to continue to practice and see what's going on. Right there, that's a predetermined pick. So, you know, yeah, okay. That seems legit. That seems legit that it's still in the game. I hope that that's gone for Madden 18. I really do, man. You know, I really, really hope that that's gone. All this predetermined stuff, because it's going to still sell. The game's going to sell. You know what I'm saying? And you can still make it bum friendly the same way. It could sell both ways, but just give people the option to turn it off and for them to have user control. That's all they really have to do. And if everybody's happy, you know what I'm saying? Everybody's happy. You guys really think that I want to complain about Madden every video, which I haven't been doing as of late. I don't really care. Like, I'm not really complaining about it. I'm just pointing out things. That's all I'm doing right now. I'm just pointing out things. Like right there, get swerved, pussy. I'm just pointing things out. Because, you know, like I said, from Madden 16 to 17, I appreciate that, you know, Rex Dixon and the developers, they actually listened to some of the things I was saying and acknowledged it in an interview that I had with them. I'm appreciative of that. And that's why I can never outright disrespect Rex, you know, like a lot of these other guys do. I can, you know, I can criticize the gameplay, but Rex is a really good dude at the end of the day. So that's just me that's just respect for another man. But the obvious thing is there's some issues that go on with the game. So all I'm going to do now, I just won't complain about it. I'm just going to point it out. You know, in stream, sometimes I just scream when it happens. You know what I'm saying? Because I can't believe it's going on. That's all I can really do. What the hell is that? Why would he throw it there when the flat route was there that I couldn't really cover the entire game? This is what I'm trying to tell you guys. When dudes are bums out here, they're just bums. And I gotta give Dubby a little bit of credit, because the more that I look at it, the skill gap is very, very small, but there is a skill gap. I have to concede to that, because I realize something. Dudes are garbage, bruh. This dude is running around with a monster squad, bruh. The dude almost had a 99 overall team. I think he probably did. And it didn't matter. My team is trash, bruh. Come to my next Twitch stream, G Myers World. My team is straight hot trash, bruh. Hot, bruh, steaming, right off the broiler, bruh. Steaming trash. But I compete. And then that's it. Oh, he kicked the ball too. Ball physics. Yo, run for six. No, we ain't running this for six. Because we ain't giving him the ball back. Because 18, 17 seconds is more than enough time to dot me. I tried to see a squad for you guys, but he's going to rage quit too fast. I was trying to go to it so I could show you the rest of his lineup, but he's going to rage quit. Really, really fast. And that's it for me. I'm going to see you guys next time. And girls. Hopefully you subscribe. One love.